Hello everybody, hope you're doing great and are ready for some volcano updates. So, it's March 19th, 2022, which means it's been a year since the eruption started in Geldingadalir after 3 weeks of intense earthquake activity that caught the attention of the world. In this video, I'm going to take a quick look at this recent eruption on the Reykjanes Peninsula and also check out the most recent activity on it. So, it's already been a year. The Geldingadalir eruption started on March 19th, 2021 at 20:45 local time. Prior to that, earthquake activity had been crazy on the peninsula. And with a lot of towns close by, and even the capital, it was felt and reported in great detail. This eruption has taught us so much about the volcanic activity on the Reykjanes Peninsula, the premonitions of eruptions, chemical compositions of the lava, and the power of eruptions. This specific eruption was also pretty interesting, since the magma feeding it came straight from the mantle, and didn't stop in a magma chamber in the meantime to mix with other elements in the crust. So the lava is pure basalt, which makes for the most beautiful eruptions in my opinion, since the lava has a low viscosity, making it almost flow like a river. In the beginning, the Geldingadalir eruption was thought to only last for a week or two at most, but it ended up being the longest continuous eruption of this century in Iceland, and it soon became a very loved eruption amongst geology enthusiasts. It also provided a lot of action through its chapter activity. For the first months of the eruption, a lot of fissures opened and the output of lava was constantly increasing, topping out at 8 cubic meters per second. Then in May, a new chapter began, which was a sort of a geyser activity, with huge lava fountains reaching heights of up to 300 meters or 984 feet. Then later, in the summer, the final chapter began, when the eruption clearly turned into a volcano-sealed eruption, which at the time made it look like this eruption was going to last for years. That phase continued throughout the summer, but in late July, the end began making itself apparent. The eruption began taking breaks, only to come back stronger after each one, which meant that the eruption pipe was being clogged due to the eruption's weak power. But in August, the lava flow reached its peak at 18 cubic meters per second, when the eruption woke up from one of its breaks and released a lot of pressure that had built up. The breaks became longer, until on the 19th of September, it took its most recent break. On that same day, the eruption in La Palma began, which is a crazy coincidence. If you noticed, I said the eruption took its most recent break. That's because it's still not certain if the eruption of Geldingadalir is over. We don't know how volcano-sealed eruptions behave, and long breaks like these could well be a common thing, since these eruptions can last for decades. The peaceful nature of the eruption made it a very popular tourist attraction, and put the town of Grindavík on the maps. In total, 366,000 people were confirmed to have visited the Geldingadalir eruption site, and there were many more that didn't make the countings because they either went by helicopter or didn't walk on the paths. But what is the most recent activity on the Reykjanes Peninsula? Well, just yesterday, a small earthquake swarm began on the peninsula just north of Grindavík, right under the Blue Lagoon. But what we've learned from the last two magma intrusions is that when magma is on the move under the peninsula, the earthquake activity is way more intense. So at the moment, this earthquake swarm does not seem to be due to a new magma intrusion. Other than that, there hasn't been much going on, just a few random sharp earthquakes. But let's speculate a bit in the speculations and prediction section. So, this most recent earthquake swarm is most likely not related to magma movement, with the largest earthquake in the recent swarm being 3 in magnitude, which was almost an average in the last two magmatic intrusions. But it's now been around 3 months since the last magma intrusion on the peninsula that caused an intense earthquake swarm that lasted for a week. That intrusion didn't make it to the surface. When that intrusion took place in late December in 2021, it had been 4 months since the eruption ended in Geldingadalir. So maybe we're seeing a cycle with magma intrusions every 4 months, which is something we've seen before in Iceland during the eruption of Krafla back in 1975 to 1984. But this is super speculative, and we have no idea how activity will be here on the Reykjanes Peninsula for the next 100 to 300 years. All we know is that it's awake, and eruptions can happen at any time now. So, we'll just have to wait and see what happens. It's crazy to think it's already been a year since the eruption started, which also means it's been a little over a year since I began making these videos. I just want to thank everyone who has watched, liked and subscribed since then. It's still hard to believe we're at 7,280 subscribers. Other than that, I just want to thank everyone who made it here, and I hope to see most of you in the next video. Thanks for watching.